showcasing one of the most famous and one of my personal favorite street food stars seen throughout the Middle East.
Cooking with Julie Tabouli is made possible by our members and by viewers like you. Thank you.
To the oh-so-sensational shaved meat sandwich shawarma, one thing is certainly for sure. The Middle East knows how to satisfy our street food senses. And today, I'm showcasing one of the most famous and one of my personal favorites of all, called kefta. This mouth-watering meat kebab is a crave-alicious combination of luscious lamb meat, fresh flat-leaf parsley, enticing aromatics, a signature spice, and skewered on a stick makes this meat kebab a showstopper that will give you a kick. Lights, camera, let's cook. It's my favorite street food star, Middle Eastern style. We are making one of the Middle East's most famous street food stars, and that is kefta. It's also called kafta. It has many different ways to say it and many different ways to spell it, but whichever way you spell it or say it, it essentially has the same ingredients, which is lamb meat, of course. It's luscious lamb meat, and then also my onion. You can see I've started to wedge this up already too. I'm using a Vidalia onion, and some parsley, and some allspice, and that allspice is really what makes kefta kefta. So I'm just kind of wedging up our onion, just like so. This is all actually gonna be made in our food processor right over here. The Middle East is known for so many great street food stars, like falafel, of course, which is famous all throughout Lebanon and the Middle East, kefta, which we're doing today, and also shawarma, meat shawarma, and chicken shawarma. The meat is kind of like shaved right off this like rotisserie spindle, similar to the Greek gyro or gyro. And this is really kind of a zesty, mouth-watering meat kebab, and I think that you guys are gonna love it. Hopefully just as much as I do, because it's one of my favorites. So I'm just gonna get our onion. I just wedged it up. We're gonna let the food processor do all of the work for us today. Hip hip hooray. And then I'm just gonna grab myself a good bunch of my favorite flat leaf parsley. That's gonna be about a third of a cup or so. It's a very, very simple, simple recipe, but it makes a masterpiece, just like so many of our Middle Eastern recipes. I'm just kind of discarding some of those larger, thicker stems, and I'm gonna leave on the thin stems because those are gonna add some nice flavor, just like so. All right, so now I'm just gonna finely mince this up in our food processor. Just let it roll. Okay, that looks perfect. You can see that I really have finely minced the parsley and the onion down, because that's gonna really blend in super, super nicely with our fresh lamb meat that we have over here. And I'm gonna add the lamb meat right into the food processor, right along with those onions and parsley, just like so. And this is about 2 pounds of lamb meat. A lot of people make this with beef as well, or you can blend the two meats, but for this recipe in particular, I really, really love what the lamb brings me. It's super succulent, it's super tender, it's super tasty. It's just delicious. Now we're gonna season this up, of course, with some sea salt and some freshly ground pepper. Make sure to season our meat really well. And half a teaspoon of freshly ground pepper. And now comes kefta's signature spice, which is our allspice. Just get this in, pull it up here. And the allspice really goes super, super well with the lamb. Traditionally, this is really how it's made, the kefta. And always when I'm doing a lamb, I really like to incorporate the allspice in with it. So I'm gonna do 1 teaspoon of the allspice. And the allspice, it's a singular spice, but it has the notes of cinnamon, clove, and nutmeg. So if you kind of wanted to also add a little bit more of those spices into this mixture, you could do that as well. So now we're just gonna give this a roll, and what we're gonna do is we're really gonna finely grind up this meat, and we're gonna incorporate all of the onions and parsley in with it, and the spices as well, and it's essentially gonna start whipping up. Okay, so I'm just gonna stop it for a moment before it starts to really whip, and I'm just gonna kind of push down the meat and make sure that everything is being incorporated evenly. It's always a good idea to do that whenever you're working with a food processor. Okay, so now we're just gonna give it one more roll and let it whip. Okay, so that is whipped up perfectly. So I'm just gonna transfer it now to our bowl. That looks super succulent. And you can see that the onions and the parsley have really blended in with that meat. This method of making my kefta this way, I take a lot of pride in, and I've done it this way. And I've found it to be super, super special. People that have had my kefta have said that it is the best that they've ever had. So I think that secret is in the way that I mix and blend and whip the meat like this. All right, so now I'm just gonna get our wooden skewers that we have soaking over here. And also I'm gonna get our grill onto high, and I'm gonna lightly oil it as well. It's essential so that they don't stick, of course. Okay, so now we're gonna get to skewering up our kefta mixture. And what I like to do is just lightly oil my hands too, just a little bit. Now, there's two ways that you can form your kefta kebabs. One is that you could just take the skewer and actually get the meat mixture and form it right on the skewer itself. Or two, the way that I'm gonna show you and the way that I like to do it, is I first form it in my hands and then I pierce the skewer through and then I squeeze it to the skewer so that it adheres really nicely. So that's what we're gonna do. I'm just gonna take myself a handful of this. And you kind of just start to kind of toss it back and forth between your hands. And you can make these as large in size or as small if you like. You could do these as little kind of appetizers, you know, or as little kind of past hors d'oeuvres or as part of the maza. You can do them little small ones, kind of to start everybody off on. Or you could do them larger like we're doing today, what you would typically find in the street, hence street food star of the Middle East. So that looks good, just like that. Okay, now I'm gonna just grab our skewer and I'm just gonna pierce the tip right through one of the other end of the stick. And now I'm just gonna kind of press the meat mixture just like so. Okay, so that skewer is all good to go. I'm just gonna lay it on our board and we're gonna do a few more here. Well, more than a few more, right? These are gonna go like hotcakes. So again, I'm just gonna grab some of my mixture. And the reason why it's a skewered meat kebab is because on the street in the Middle East, obviously it's a street food, so that way the vendor could just hand the kebab just like so right over to the person and they can enjoy it on the street. And the other reason is that they could literally just slide the meat right off the skewer into the warm pita pocket and all of those accompaniments and the sauces. And then, of course, you can just go ahead and enjoy it right on the street, on street food. And who just doesn't love meat on a stick? I think every culture has their own version of meat on a stick, so definitely can't go wrong. So I'm just finishing up our last kefta kebab, and I'm just gonna pierce it through, just like we have the other ones done as well. I'm just gonna squeeze it again right on that skewer, just like so. They're gonna grill up so beautifully. Cannot wait. Have my little street food star for today. All right, so I have my grill pan nice and hot, and I've lightly oiled it as well, so that way our skewers don't stick. Just gonna grab them, and right before you put them on the grill, you just wanna kind of squeeze them a little bit more, just to make sure they're good to go. Okay, and I'm just gonna put them right on. Ooh, sizzling up. Love it. Just gonna leave a little space in between each one, just like so. And these are gonna grill on each side for about 4 to 5 minutes. It's lamb, which means it's lean, so we definitely don't wanna over grill our kifta kebabs. We want them really nice and succulent. Super tasty. I think it's funny because the word kifta means to beat or to grind. So, a little interesting factoid about the name. So the thing about kifta, when you're grilling most meats, you definitely want to man the grill. You definitely want to keep your eye on it because we definitely don't want to over-grill our kebabs. Now you can also broil these in the oven if you'd like. It just has to be at a high temperature of about 450 degrees. And the same thing, they're going to broil for about 10 to 12, 15 minutes tops, and you're going to turn them halfway through. My kifta kebabs grilled up so succulent. They're sizzling and succulent, love it. I'm just gonna cover them now with some warm pita bread, and that's gonna do two things. It's gonna help to keep them nice and warm and hot for us while we create our other toppings and sauce that's gonna go with our kifta kebabs for today. And it's also gonna help to soak up all those great natural juices that are coming from the kifta kebabs too. So now it's time for our tasty, tasty topping that's gonna go right on top of our kifta kebabs, and I call it a harmonization of caramelization. Basically what it is, it's a medley of all these fresh flavors and tastes and textures, and it all starts with some beautiful big bell peppers that I have over here. I'm gonna do a green, a yellow, I'm gonna grab myself an orange, and a red too. All the colors of the rainbows, or almost all the colors of the rainbows. So I'm just gonna slice off the tops, just take the seeds right out there, and I'm just gonna slice them going right across in ringlets. And we're gonna start with all of our peppers that we have here. I love this so much with the kifta. I came up with this couple years ago. I was making kifta so much, and I wanted different toppings for it. So I kind of just started putting a whole medley of all these different vegetables and fresh herbs together. And I made it for my sister and my brother one day, and they loved it. So I was like, okay, I got a hit in my hands. And it's gonna be extra, extra delicious with our kifta kebabs that we have. Ooh, this is a giant, ginormous green pepper. It's beautiful. I think I'm actually gonna slice this one in half and then go across. So typically the kifta kebab, you can just have it right in the pita bread, just as is, very simple. Or you could top it with similar toppings like we do with falafel, like lettuce, tomato, onions, things like that. Pickled vegetables too, if you like liffet, which is our pickled turnips, or pickled cucumber. But I really like to top it with this medley that I'm doing here. I think that you guys will love it as well. So I'm just gonna oil our pan, our sheet pan here. And everything is gonna go right onto the sheet pan. We're gonna mix it all up right onto the sheet pan. Look at that, so beautiful. We're also gonna be adding a little bit of a kick, a little bit of hot pepper. Just gonna mix that right in. Okay, and now it's time for our aromatics. I'm gonna grab myself a Vidalia onion. I'm gonna grab myself a red onion. I'm gonna grab myself a couple shallots. And some garlic. And this is all gonna go in as well. I love this dish too, because you can see it's so colorful. It's so inspiring. I love the contrast of that kind of earthiness of our meat kebabs, our kifta kebabs, and you have all this brightness with these vegetable medleys. It's gonna look super spectacular on the plate. It's all about pleasing the eye and the palate, right? Both. Okay, so now we're gonna grab some baby bella mushrooms, and I'm just going to wipe these off, and we're just gonna quarter these up very simply. You could also use creminis if you like, or portobello mushrooms would be good too. Okay, so that's it for our baby bella mushrooms. Gonna get these right in too. I left them quartered because as they roast in the oven, they're definitely gonna kind of wilt down a little bit, so you wanna still make sure that you have a bite of that mushroom in. Okay, so now time for all of our fresh herbs, of course. We're gonna get our scallions, some green onions. 5 should do it. and some flat leaf parsley, a good whole handful of this, and some chives too. Nice handful of those, and some fresh mint as well. So I just gave all of our fresh herbs a nice rough chop, and now I'm gonna get those onto our sheet pan as well. Look at all this vibrant green color and fresh flavor. I left it like a rough chop because I really want those fresh herbs to come through in the roasting and in the finishing. And now we're gonna give this all a little bit of a kick with hot pepper. Just a little bit. I'm just gonna roughly chop this as well. Okay, so now I'm just gonna add these in. Sprinkle them right on top. And now it's time to dress all of this up with, you know what's coming, my extra virgin olive oil. I'm gonna go generous with this. I wanna make sure that we have enough olive oil for all of our fresh vegetables and our herbs. Okay, beautiful. Now, waking everything up with, you know what, my fresh lemon. Just gonna squeeze this right over. And then just a little bit of sea salt and some freshly ground pepper, and that should do it. Smells delicious. I could eat it just like this. All right, now I'm just gonna toss it all together with my fingers. Kind of blend everything so it becomes one. Clean hands, of course. The cook's best friend. Oops, there goes a mushroom. Okay, that looks good to go. So now I'm just gonna get this into our oven. It's preheated at 450 degrees, and these are gonna roast for about 20 minutes, 20 to 25 minutes actually. Something that I just love about shopping in a specialty food store. I love the unique and intimate atmosphere and of course the wide array of specialty ingredients that you can find. And today it's all about tahini. I'm going to share with you my top tips on tahini. And basically what tahini is a sesame seed paste, which is clearly labeled on all of the different brands that they have. I really like going for a brand like this because it's in a clear glass jar, or also they have it in a clear plastic jar, so you can clearly see the quality of the tahini. You can see that it's really nice and smooth, and it has a really nice color to it as well. And you can also clearly see the paste level versus the oil level that settles naturally to the top. And what I mean by that is there's not a whole lot of oil that's settling to the top, so that's definitely a good sign because that means that the paste itself is gonna be much more smoother and creamier, kind of have a really nice fluid consistency, and that's definitely what you're looking for, especially when you're making our signature tahini sauce like we're making today for our street food star, our kifta. So after you open your tahini, simply keep it in your pantry in a cool, dry area. There's actually no need to refrigerate the tahini. And the other reason why I really love to buy my tahini at a specialty food store versus a major grocery store, they're constantly being bought by different customers, so you know that it's not sitting on the shelf a long time, which is definitely another really good key indication that you're gonna have good quality tahini, just like me. Just stirring up our tahini, our sesame seed paste, and I'm incorporating the oil with the paste because with tahini, the oil naturally settles to the top, so you definitely want to incorporate it really well so you have a nice even distribution. See how fluid that is? It's light and airy, and it's going to make for a delicious signature sauce, our tahini sauce. Okay, so I'm going to start off with finely mincing a couple cloves of garlic, about three. I'm gonna finely mince those up first. And this is really our classic tahini sauce, meaning the base is really just the garlic and the tahini, the sesame seed paste, and the lemon, a little bit of water and sea salt. But I'm gonna add some fresh herbs into this as well. I really want the fresh herb flavor to come through, and I think it's gonna really enhance those kifta kebabs really nicely as well. So I'm just gonna add a handful of our flat leaf parsley in, just like so. And I'm also gonna add in a little bit of fresh mint leaves too. So I'm just gonna take the leaves off the mint. And that's what's so great about the tahini sauce, is that you can really kind of, you know, make the simple one, which is the base, which I just spoke about, just the garlic and the tahini and the lemon, or you can add any of your fresh herbs to it too and sort of kind of, you know, spruce it up, make it different. So I'm just gonna finely mince this up. Okay, just like so, that's perfect. So now we are going to ladle in about a cup of our tahini, our sesame seed paste. I'm just gonna eyeball it. Look at that. I think three ladles should give us about one cup. Just like so. Okay, wonderful. And now, I'm gonna add in about a third of a cup of cold water. And I'm just gonna give this a whirl really quickly. I just wanna incorporate the water with the sesame seed paste before we add in our fresh lemon and our sea salt. Just a quick whirl, just to get that paste kind of going. All right, so now we're gonna add, of course, lemons, which really make this tahini sauce spectacular. We're gonna do about 3 to 4 lemons, and we will see if we need more. Sometimes you need a little bit more lemon juice, but we'll take a look at it. Okay, so now I'm just gonna get our fresh lemon juice right into our food processor. Just gonna strain it from any of the seeds. Just pour it right over, just like so. That looks good. And now, I'm just gonna add in about 1 teaspoon of our sea salt. Okay, we're gonna give this a whirl, and we're gonna see how it looks. Okay, let's take a look at our tahini. Oh, that's perfect. See that? So that's all you need. If you want to make it a little bit thicker, you can add more tahini. If you want to make it a little bit thinner, you can add more fresh lemon juice or cold water, whichever you like, depending upon how lemony you like it. So I'm just gonna give this a quick taste, really quick, and we're gonna get it into our bowl. Make sure we're on point. Yummy. Love tahini. I know why. It is the most famous sauce in the Middle East. Look at all those fresh herbs. Isn't that beautiful? The fresh parsley and the fresh mint just kind of running through it. Our tahini sauce is so tasty and it is good to go. And I can smell that our caramelized peppers and onions and aromatics, I think they are almost ready. Our tasty topping, look at this. All of our caramelized onions and peppers and mushrooms and fresh herbs and aromatics. Look how nice they've caramelized up. And now I'm just gonna plate these up. And these are gonna be that tasty, tasty topping for our kifta kebabs. I'm actually just gonna pick up my whole pan and just start to pour it right over. Look at that. They're cooked perfectly too, because they really kind of have caramelized nicely. You can see that they still have their shape to them, which is always nice, and a nice bite as well. Okay, so now it's time to make myself a kifta kebab, my street food star sandwich. So I'm just gonna reveal here our kifta kebabs that I covered with our pita bread. And I'm gonna show you how we do it. So we just take our pita pocket and just skewer it right off the stick, just like that. I wanna have a little bit of my tahini sauce, my tasty tahini sauce with all of my fresh herbs right on top of it. And then I'm gonna add more on the entire sandwich too. And now I'm just gonna get some of my caramelized onions and peppers. Look at that, oh, so delicious. It's so colorful too. Such a spectacular street food star. I love it so much. Okay, now I'm gonna add a little bit more of that tahini, just like that. Oh my gosh, look how delicious this looks, really. This is a street food star. And now I'm just gonna roll it right up. And we're gonna go for what we've all been waiting for, that delicious bite. So good. The kifta is so succulent, that lamb meat and the onions and the parsley and that allspice. And then we have our caramelized onions and peppers and herbs. And the tasty tahini sauce just tips this right over the scales. I hope that you enjoyed making my street food star with me today. And as always, I wish you and yours to always take global hana.
On the next Cooking with Julie Tabouli.
I'm in heaven with my two Middle Eastern signature sweet treats, harissa and halab dil jibni, and horses.
On the next Cooking with Julie Tabouli. Cooking with Julie Tabouli is made possible by our members and by viewers like you. Thank you.